Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Dr. Uchenna and today I want to discuss about healing from tragic circumstances, healing from a tragedy in your past, it's always in your past, healing from trauma, so I can only talk from my own personal experience, and I know most of us may be familiar with the five stages of grief, and that's not what I'm here to talk about. I'm just here to tell you about how I was able to overcome my own challenge and put my life back on track, so it seems. I believe it's back on track, and that's why I'm here to discuss it. So, I lost my job and I lost everything I had worked for over 9 to 10 years. So the whole career, everything I was building before, suddenly crashed one day, and of course it was my fault. So I've taken full responsibility for the situations and for the decisions and the actions that led to the destruction. So it may not be the same for everybody. We all have different kinds of losses that we endure in life, but there's no way you can go through life without losing things. Life is a process of loss and renewal. For some people it starts, everybody's journey is different. So for some people it starts better, there's steady progress, then there's a decline. But it always happens, there's always that decline there. So it's how you deal with it when it comes that I'm here to talk about. So it's not something that can really be generalized. It can only be generalized if the circumstances are similar. So, first of all, what I did, was to tell myself the truth about myself and to take responsibility for the actions that I had taken in the past, even if they were influenced by other people or, cultural conditioning and all the other elements that can distract us. And not really being where you should be, because I knew from the beginning that the career choice I had made wasn't aligned to my strengths, was not aligned to my values about life, was not aligned to my destiny, basically. And I was running away from my destiny. That was why I ran into, a place of safety, which turned out not to be safe. So that's a different lesson for a different day. The first thing, I did was, of course, the five stages of grief are there. I endured, I had to endure the grief, the pain, the cries, and everything. I had to accept it, first of all. And by acceptance, I mean telling myself the truth about, my journey and where I had been. So it took a lot of reflection, reflecting on the past and reflecting on my decisions, and also reflecting on the future. I know reflect is not the right word to speak about the future, but I was, you can reflect on how you think your future, or your present should be. Then, of course, being in the present moment, I had to accept where I was and accept what I had lost, went through the grieving process. And it's just that truth that we tell ourselves within ourselves. The truth is not the truth. The truth is your truth. And your truth is not universal. Your truth is specifically meant for you. It's specifically meant to heal you. That's what I mean when I say truth. Truth here, I mean, is subjective. Your interpretation of your life journey. Your understanding about who you are and, who you should be and what you need to be doing to be happy and to live a fulfilled life. Yeah, so that was the process. That was the first part of the process I had to go through. It was an internally disorganizing, heart-wrenching discussion I had to have with myself. So then the second step, was to forgive myself for my misdirected actions. for the choices that I made in the past that were not beneficial, for not being courageous enough to be myself, for not being authentic to my inner calling, for being afraid of pursuing my real passion and actualizing my true potential, for hiding behind shame, and for running away from my challenges. So I had to forgive myself for all those things I had done. And of course, it took a lot of other processes like journaling, talking to myself, speaking to other people. And yeah, that was the, that's the second aspect of the healing process. The second one is very important. Remember, you have to forgive yourself. And true forgiveness means that you should understand that it wasn't, I wouldn't say it wasn't your fault. Remember, there are two parts of you. There's the ego and there's the unseen, there's the spiritually powerful spirit inside you. There's the courageous part of you, that can do anything. So the ego always gets in the way of you being yourself. The ego provides a cover, like, it provides shame and fear and anxiety and self-doubt. It uses those tools to cage you, to cage your authentic self, so that you don't come out and express yourself. And those blockages, so for allowing your ego to do that, you need to forgive yourself because you were not strong enough. I wasn't strong enough at the time, so that was why I went through what I went through. Then number three is to change your belief system, your belief structure, your understanding about reality and about what has occurred. So your belief, of course, is the engine that runs your life, and you need to change your mindset. That's a whole program for of doing. You need to change your mindset, and your mindset will is what will determine, how you move forward. So you have to believe that everything is here to help you, and everything really is here to help you. Even the tragedy itself has come to help you in a way. And remember that tragedy is part of life. There's no way we cannot do without it. It's not possible to go through life without having tragic circumstances. Tragedy is going to come because you have a family, you have people you care for, you have a job, you have whatever this and this and that, and you can lose it at any time. You can lose any of it. You can lose all of it. So we need to brace ourselves up for those tragic circumstances. Number four is a bit controversial. Speaking to people, it's not everybody you speak to because information is on a need-to-know basis. So you need to talk to people that you trust really well. You need to talk to people that you have the confidence in that they can help you out of your, or not help you, but they can even listen to you, without judgment. So those people are the people that you can share your truth with, because I believe that when you share your truth by speaking, you heal yourself in a way because you're releasing that energy, that toxic, constricting, force that's within you. If you're able to release it will release a lot of things just by speaking it out. In my last video, I was talking about the power of words. So by speaking it out is cathartic. That's why we have counselors, we have coaches, we have ministers, people that you go to tell your problems on a professional basis. And the reason for doing that is just to let you speak it out in a place where nobody's going to judge you. And that's a very powerful healing modality. Then the fifth one, was what I did, was to change my environment. Not everybody's going to be in that position to just go away or change your environment or something like that. But if you can, it's always the best, depending on what your issues were before. So your environment, we are beginning to understand science even. I mean, there's scientific evidence, that the environment plays a lot of role, plays plenty roles, in our genetic makeup, it influences our behavior, it influences our life, so you need to understand your environmental aspects. So you need to change it if you have to, and if it's very necessary. Starting afresh means changing that environment. And yeah, those are the tips I have for you today, and I'll see you on the next video. Bye.